Fifth Sunday of Easter, I bid you peace, joy, and love. Welcome to this virtual worship service for Church of the Master Presbyterian Church, USA. We are delighted that you've chosen to worship with us on this Lord's Day. Come with us now as we go forth in intentional worship of our triune God.
Greetings. Please join me for a call to worship. Let everything that has being praise the name of the Lord. Mountains and hills, fruit trees and all cedars shall praise the name of the Lord. Young men and women alike, old and young together shall praise the name of the Lord. We praise you, O God, for your glory is above earth and heaven. With praise and adoration, let us worship God. Pray with me, Church of the Master Family. Magnificent, preeminent, all above any word that we can think of, God, Creator, we love you, we adore you, we stand in awe of everything that you have created, everything that you continue to create. We ask that you forgive us of all of our sins, both known and unknown. We ask that you give us a spur throughout every crisis moment that we face throughout our week, every decision point. We ask that you give us energy, give us your spirit, all that makes the impossible possible. We ask for that in our lives. We come to you seeking correction in our errors. We come to you seeking mercy for our sins. And we know that through your presence and your presence alone, we can get anything done that is required for us to do on this earth. It's in the mighty name of Jesus Christ that we offer this prayer. Amen, amen, and amen. Thank you.
to confession, trusting in the love of God, God's ability to make all things new. Let us now confess our misdeeds, our missteps, yes, indeed, our sins before God by praying now our prayer of confession. Let us pray. God of mercy, your command to love one another across all differences opens us to new horizons. Yet we often respond with fear and judgment that hinders your goal for humanity. Forgive our sins, we pray, and give us a true repentance that leads to life for all of creation. We pray in Jesus' name, amen. Beloved, hear the good news, and it is good news. God's promises are trustworthy and true. So I declare to you in the name of Jesus Christ that you are, I am, we are forgiven. Now go, do likewise, and be at peace. And may you always be known by your love. We turn now to the proclamation of the word portion of our worship service for this Lord's Day. After our prayer of illumination, our scripture readings for today will be as follows. The Old Testament lesson comes from the Psalter. It is Psalm 148 in its entirety. And the New Testament lesson comes from the Revelation of John, chapter 21, verses 1 through 6. Pray with me, please. O God of promise, your word made flesh in Jesus Christ is trustworthy and true. By the power of your Holy Spirit, may it rise up in us this day like a gift from the spring of the water of life to refresh our thirsty souls. Amen. Amen.
Our Old Testament reading today will come from the book of Psalms, chapter 148. Listen for the word of God. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord from the heavens. Praise him in the heights above. Praise him, all his angels. Praise him, all his heavenly hosts. Praise him, sun and moon. Praise him, all you shining stars. Praise him, you highest heavens and you waters above the skies. Let them praise the name of the Lord, for at his command they were created. And he established them forever and ever. He issued a decree that will never pass away. Praise the Lord from the earth, you great sea creatures in all ocean depths. Lightning and hail, snow and clouds, stormy winds that do his bidding. You mountains and all hills, fruit trees and all cedars. Wild animals and all cattle, small creatures and flying birds, kings of the earth and all nations. You princes and all rulers on earth, young men and women, old men and children, let them praise the name of the Lord, for his name alone is exalted. His splendor is above the earth and the heavens, and he has raised up for his people a horn. The praise of all his faithful servants of Israel, the people close to his heart. Praise the Lord. This is the word of God for the people of God.
The New Testament lesson comes from Revelation chapter 21, verse 1 through 6. Listen for the word of the Lord. Then I saw a new heaven and a new earth, for the first heaven and the first earth had passed away, and there was no longer any sea. I saw the holy city coming down out of heaven from God, prepared as a bride, beautifully dressed for her husband. And I heard a loud voice from the throne saying, look, God's dwelling place is now among the people, and he will dwell with them. They will be his people, and God himself will be with them and be their God. He will wipe every tear from their eyes. There will be no more death or mourning or crying or pain. For the old order of things had passed away. He who was seated and on the throne said, I am making everything new. Then he said, write this down, for these words are trustworthy and true. He said to me, It is done. I am the Alpha and the Omega, the beginning and the end. To the thirsty, I will give water without cost from the spring of the water of life. The word of the Lord.
This fifth Sunday of Easter, I bid you peace, joy, and love. The sermon once again finds its basis in our lectionary readings for today. In addition to the scriptures that have already been read, hear these excerpts now from our other two passages. From the Acts of the Apostles, chapter 11, verses 1 through 18, hear now this pericope. Now the apostles and the believers who were in Judea heard that the Gentiles had also accepted the word of God. So when Peter went up to Jerusalem, the circumcised believers criticized him, saying, "Why did you go to uncircumcised men and eat with them? If then God gave them the same gift that he gave us when we believed in the Lord Jesus Christ, who was I that I could hinder God?" When they heard this, they were silenced, and they praised God, saying, "Then God has given even to the Gentiles the repentance that leads to life." And hear these words from the Gospel according to John, chapter 13, verses 34 through 35. The evangelist records, "I give you a new commandment, that you love one another just as I have loved you. You also should love one another. By this, everyone will know that you are my disciples, if you love one another. Beloved, for just a little while, I'd like to speak now from the subject, United in Love. United in Love. Pray with me, please. Gracious God, in the resurrection of Jesus Christ, you make all things new. In your word, you have called your church to a love beyond all social and cultural differences. In our acceptance of you, you gave us the gift of your Holy Spirit to open our hearts to enact such love. We pray now that in this preaching moment, you will give us that same spirit of openness so that we might too discern new directions in our day, that we might live our lives united in a love and a spirit like yours. Help us now, dear God, to center ourselves in your word proclaimed. Touch us anew through the power of your Holy Spirit, that we might be enlightened, transformed, and empowered by your love. Now, God, for as much as without thee we're not able to please thee, mercifully grant that thy Holy Spirit may in all things that follow direct and rule our hearts through Jesus Christ our Lord, we pray. Amen. Amen. United in love. In the mid-1960s, while this nation was living through a season of social justice, reckoning, redemption, and reconciliation, a Catholic priest living in Evanston, Illinois, named Father Peter Skoltis, wrote a song for his youth group. Now, this song is based on our gospel lesson for today, specifically on verse 35, which we just read, that says, "By this, everyone will know that you are my disciples if you have love for one another." Hear now the words of the song Father Skoltis wrote. He wrote, "We are one in the Spirit, we are one in the Lord. We are one in the Spirit, we are one in the Lord. And we pray that our unity may one day be restored, and they'll know we are Christians by our love. Yes, they'll know that we are Christians by our love. We will work with each other. We will work side by side. We will work with each other. We will work side by side. And we'll guard each man's dignity and save each man's pride. And they'll know that we are Christians by our love, by our love. Yes, they'll know we are Christians by our love." I hope that you will let the words of that song run in the background during our time together in the proclaimed word. Conflicts and conspiracies, discord, divisions, disagreements, these are the constants in our 21st century reality. The polarization and divisions of the here and now, well, they are probably rooted in the social reforms of the 1960s. Those of us who have experienced a few revolutions around the sun, or those of us who are avid students of history, can see the thread that extends from the social movements of the 20th century to our present day situation. Yes, they're there if you look. The back and forth, the power grabbing, the need to dominate and isolate, the desire to exclude. We just don't seem to want to settle down and live on common ground. So we choose to create chaos rather than be united in love. And make no mistake about it, this is our choice. Beloved, Christians, Jews, and Muslims share a common ancestor in the faith and a common commandment to love God and to love neighbor. Yet through the years, instead of being united by this common call to love, we have chosen to primarily identify ourselves by those things that divide us, those things that separate us, those things that cause us not to be one body. Things like what we wear, what we eat, how we order our lives. This divisive behavior extends itself even into our faith communities and even into families that identify themselves as Christians. Yes, it is common to see fissures and fractures in our family over interpretation of scripture, understanding of authority, and acceptance of tradition. Even as those we love claim to have Christ in their lives, they claim that Christ is the center, that Christ is their Savior. Even with that, they are ready to do battle over what is in their Bible or what God has revealed to them. Yes, today so many make life choices, establish moral codes based on a selfish, self-serving understanding of love. And in doing so, they exclude much of humanity and some of their immediate family from their sphere of love. Beloved, we are called to be united in love. Jesus says it in his farewell address that just as he has loved us, we are to love one another. So the question might be, how does Christ love us? Well, we know that Christ humbled himself. He served, he sought out and cared for those living on the margins, those isolated, those deemed as other or somehow unfit or unworthy by the larger group. Yes, as he loved, he saw the humanity in everyone. And he loved all as children of the Most High God. And we see the same kind of inclusion, the same how to love spoken of in our Acts text for today. But in that text, it is God in the third person, God as the Holy Spirit this time that moves on the heart of the members of the Jerusalem Council. You know, Peter was called to justify his sharing the good news of Jesus Christ with the people the council deemed unworthy. And in that moment, he was being criticized and judged by his own people for sharing and showing the love of Jesus Christ with those they deemed as profane and less than, because of the community and the customs they were born into. And I hope you see it from the story that when the Holy Spirit came through, it wasn't about Peter converting them to Judaism through the way or changing their moral code and customs. No, it was about inclusion, the recognizing of all God's creation as good and good enough to love. Beloved, how often have we refused to see another as good enough. How often have we made the conscious decision to ignore another's humanity? Daily we see it played out in the loss of life, random shootings, mass shootings, wars, and loss of life based on ideology. Daily we see it played out in our lack of caring and community, our placing of self-interest over that of our neighbor. Yes, today that is referred to as our freedom or our liberty, or even as religious liberty. These things are our new normal. Still, we claim to be imitators of Christ, and we call ourselves by his name. As an aside, I would venture to say that worldwide, if all who are called by Christ's names had been imitators of Christ's love at the beginning of this pandemic and continued in that posture to this day, I would hazard to guess that right now all of humanity would be in a much better place. Yes, our current reality is that the courtesy and the kindness that comes with seeing people as Christ did, loving and taking care of one another as Christ commanded and as he lived out, being humble imitators of Christ's love, is so often the exception to the rule. Sadly, even in the body of Christ, sadly, even in the church. Beloved, the truth of it is to be true imitators of Christ, showing and sharing the love of Christ in your daily walk means this on the positive side. It means in your daily walk, you will experience joy and peace in the most unlikely places. It means on the positive side, in your daily walk, you will experience love and comfort in the most unlikely places. And it means on the positive side, in your daily walk, you will catch glimpses and live in little moments of God's new heaven and new earth in the most unlikely places. And it also means on the negative side, that you will sometimes be mocked and vilified because of your love. It means there will be occasions when your love is abused and misunderstood. It means there will be times when you will be isolated and ostracized because of your love. But beloved, rest assured, when those negative moments come, and they will come, you can count on our triune God showing up in whatever person the situation calls for, be it God, be it Jesus Christ, be it the Holy Spirit. You can count on God showing up and making things right. Know that God may not show up when you want, but trust that God will be there on time. Beloved, we know that to be united in Christ, we must be imitators of Christ's love. And if we are to be imitators of Christ's love, we must act in love. So how do we act in love? Peter showed us a wonderful openness in our Acts lesson that demonstrates how to act in love. And as we continue to look into scripture, we see that the apostle Paul also suggests the ways that we should act in love. In Romans 12:9, he says, let love be genuine. Hate what is evil, hold fast to what is good. Love one another with mutual affection. Outdo one another in showing honor. Do not lag in zeal. Be ardent in spirit. Serve the Lord. In Colossians 3:12, Paul says, as God's chosen ones, holy and beloved, clothe yourselves with compassion, kindness, humility, meekness, and patience. Bear with one another. And if anyone has a complaint against another, forgive each other. Just as the Lord has forgiven you, so you also must forgive. Above all, clothe yourself with love, which binds everything together in perfect harmony. United in love, acting in love, being imitators of Christ. In the first letter of John, chapter 4, verse 7, we are reminded to, hear this now, to love one another because love is from God. And everyone who loves is born of God and knows God. And whoever does not love does not know God. For God is love. Acting in love. United in love. St. Francis is quoted as saying, preach the gospel at all times. Use words when necessary. Preach the gospel at all times. Use words when necessary. Beloved, that is a quaint reminder that being imitators of Christ and being united in love is more about what we do than what we say. And isn't that the way love is? We can speak it, we can shout it, we can sing it. But if our character and our countenance do not demonstrate it, our words are in vain. As I close this little word, there's one more thing that our lections teach about love. In Psalm 148 and Revelation 21, we're reminded that love is the way to give God glory. Love is why we cry out holy and give all praises to our God. And love is at the heart of our worship in church, our worship in our daily walk with God. United in love. The question is, how are you doing with that? Do you act in love? Do people recognize who and whose you are by your love? It's my hope and my prayer that the answer to this is yes. Pray with me, please. Loving God, you fulfill the desire of all who call upon you. We worship, praise your name, and thank you for being God in our lives. You are faithful in words, gracious in deeds, just in all ways, and kind in all that you do. You keep us in your tender care, and Lord God, when we stray, you seek us out and return us to the fold. Your love for us knows no bounds. We pray now that as we continue on this journey in life, that we will act in love, that we will in word and in deed be imitators of you, and that as we grow in grace and in love, people will see in our character and our countenance your love. This is our prayer. In the name of the Creator, the Savior, and the Sustainer. Amen. Amen. To the service of giving for this Lord's Day. Thank you for the generosity that you have shown this ministry. Beloved, Scripture tells us that Jesus said, I give you a new commandment, that you love one another. Just as I have loved you, you also should love one another. With that scripture in mind, let us give with gladness to our God by offering the gifts of our labor, life, and our love. Please give. Again, thank you for your generosity. Pray with me, please. Loving God, we recognize that all things come from Thee, and it's from Thine own that we have given Thee. Lord God, we give You thanks for the ministry of reconciliation to which You have called us in the name of Jesus Christ. We pray now that You will accept these gifts for Your mission to heal all creation. May they be a testament to Your love for us as we share them in love for You. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord, we pray. Amen. Amen. Parting word, we like to thank our worship leaders for this Lord's Day. Elder Zettler Clay IV, serving as our liturgist. Will Trice reading scripture. Deacon Courtney Trice for our time for children. As always, our virtual musicians, Mrs. Sheila Wheat Harris, Miss Esther Renee Clark, and Deacon Lila Bolden, and our video producer, Elder Anthony Meadows. Beloved, take this charge. Jesus has loved us so that we may love others. So go forth in peace to love and to serve God. And now unto Him who is able to keep you from falling and to present you faultless before the presence of His glory with rejoicing. To the only wise God, our Savior, be glory, majesty, dominion, and power. Now, henceforth, and forevermore. Amen. Amen. Until we gather again in this virtual space, I am the Reverend Dr. Cecilia A. Taylor, pastor of Church of the Master Presbyterian Church, USA, located in Atlanta, Georgia. We do hope to see you soon.